Hi, this is Chef Nick from Tony's Market. Welcome to my kitchen. This week, we're taking on the tri-tip steak, a particularly delicious triangular-shaped cut from the tip of the sirloin, hence the name tri-tip. It first became popular in Santa Maria, California, where it grew into the Santa Maria barbecue, a cult classic paired with beans, salsa, salad, and garlic bread. The tri-tip is awesome on the grill, either seasoned or marinated. We also offer it already in our Santa Maria-style marinade, essentially a bourbon teriyaki. Quite tasty, I must say. The tri-tip is so tasty, it's actually become a favorite cut for chili cook-offs. Grilling is great, but don't stop there. It also makes a tasty steak, kebab, satay, stir-fry, stroganoff, chili, meat pies, or even beef bourguignon. Sit back for a moment and join me in my kitchen as we tackle the beef tri-tip family steak. This is the tri-tip. It can be cut into steaks or strips, seasoned and grilled whole, or bring home one of our marinated Santa Maria tri-tips for the grill. We'll start the night before with my Hawaiian marinade, perfect for the adventurous cook. 1/4 cup garlic, 2 tablespoons ginger, 1/2 cup oyster sauce, 2 tablespoons sambal oleg or chili garlic sauce, 1/2 cup sugar, 1/4 cup sesame seeds, 1 cup soy sauce, 1/4 cup of green onions, and 1/2 cup of water. Of course, you can always save time and money with our marinades. I highly recommend our Santa Maria, sweet chili ginger, or this excellent local teriyaki. Let's cut our first tri-tip into half-inch steaks. While we're not crossing the grain at perfectly at 90 degrees, we're shortening the muscle fibers, making the meat more tender. Some of this is going into beef stroganoff, so we'll trim away the fat, but not too much. I like to do bite-sized strips an inch or so long. Of course, our butchers can do all of this for you at no charge. We'll marinate these smaller steaks and slices in any of the marinades mentioned for a quick steak, a beef donburi, and satays. Marinate 6 to 12 hours. I separated the satay meat from the steaks, threading it onto skewers and folding as needed. The key here is to not pack it too tight. Now these are ready to grill. There is no substitute for genuine hardwood chunks and a good grill or smoker. We'll push the coals aside so we have a hot direct side and a low indirect side. This works well on any grill, even a gas grill. Alternatively, you could use a lower temperature on a smoker, Traeger, or Big Green Egg. The cooking steps are classic. Sear both sides and then move to indirect heat to finish more slowly. As the roast finishes, we'll cook up our satays. Again, I like a quick sear and then a slower finish. To reduce temperature, restrict the airflow. Most grills have an exhaust port on top and an intake port on the bottom. Less airflow means lower fire temperature. The satay are done. These cook fast, be prepared. A poke of the tri-tip tells me it needs a little more time. We'll come back in 5 minutes. As always, we need to check internal temperatures early. I think the ideal temperature range for a tri-tip is between 120 and 130 degrees. But temping is not an exact science. Check several spots. Notice how it varies near the edges versus the center, and you'll naturally have spots to cook more than others. Focus more on the lower numbers, and remember, you can always cook it more, but there's no way to uncook it. I'm estimating it's about 125 degrees internal, so off the fire to a platter to rest for 10 to 30 minutes. This seems like the natural way to slice, but wait a minute. If we look back at the raw roast, we can see the grain really starts in the corner, so we'll rotate the roast and slice as close to 90 degrees as possible, on a bias, and as thin as we can. Final slicing is important. I suggest a proper slicing knife be kept sharp and only for this purpose. It'll keep your fingers safer and your meals will look and taste better. Let's get back to the petite steaks we marinated. Sear quickly in a hot, heavy pan, nearly 500 degrees. We want a fast sear on the outside, but to keep them a little pink on the inside. And no, juices don't get sealed inside with searing. That's just silly. Sear in small batches and drizzle with our sweet chili ginger marinade. It's a great serving sauce too. Rest 5 to 10 minutes and serve. These would be equally good in any combination of these marinades. Or you can slice the steaks for donburi, rice bowl in English. Or try rice or udon noodles. These tasty bowls are also a great way to use up leftover steak. Top a warm bowl of rice or noodles with cut veggies. Carrots, cucumbers, celery, scallions, shredded lettuce are all great. Then pile on the soft meat. Extra flavorful steak is the key to great donburi. Teriyaki marinated meat finishing our sweet chili ginger is hard to beat. Now we're going to use some of our tri-tip slices to make a simple but excellent beef stroganoff. To 1.5 pounds of tri-tip strips, we'll add 3/4 teaspoon each of Tony's Crazy Salt and Pepper and 1 to 2 tablespoons of flour. Toss and then sear quickly in 2 to 3 tablespoons of olive oil. Just like our steaks, brown quickly and attentively over high heat and remove when still pink on the inside. Small batches are the best way to do this. Now reduce the heat to medium and add 2 tablespoons butter and about a cup of chopped onion, cooking to soften, 4 to 5 minutes. Next, stir in about a half teaspoon of minced garlic and 8 ounces of sliced cremini or white mushrooms. These will cook for another 4 minutes or so, and then we'll add 2 tablespoons of flour, tossing and continue to cook the flour for 1 minute. Now we've set the stage to make the sauce. 14 ounces of beef stock, 2 teaspoons of Worcestershire, 1 to 2 teaspoons Dijon mustard, and 3/4 teaspoons of dry thyme, or better yet, 2 teaspoons of fresh thyme. Bring it to a boil and reduce for several minutes to thicken. Then add back the beef and all the juices in the bowl. The beef is fully cooked, so we really just want to warm it through. Simmering it for more than a minute or two could make it dry. Finally, turn off the heat and stir in about a half cup of sour cream to finish and bring the temperature down. Take care not to boil at this point or the cream will break and the sauce will lose its magic. Just get everything warmed through and it's time to serve. Beef stroganoff is one of my favorite excuses to eat pappardelle egg pasta. I am crazy about its springy texture. Toss with a little butter, then pile on the meat sauce. Fresh parsley is the perfect crowning touch. If you forget to bring it home like I did, dry parsley will do, or just skip it. The beef tri-tip has become a mainstream classic. We've been cutting it at Tony's since the early 80s, along with a host of other hard-to-find, high-value cuts. Here are my secrets for success. Think of the tri-tip as an affordable family steak. Slice thin, and you only need about 4 to 8 ounces per person. Soak roasts or steaks in our Santa Maria marinade, brown quickly, and move to low or indirect heat to finish slowly. They're also great on a smoker, a Big Green Egg, or a Traeger grill. For the best results, cook to about medium rare, avoiding rare or medium. At rare, it's a bit tough, and at medium, it can sometimes be a bit dry. Identify the grain direction and then slice thinly across the grain for the most tender meat. And the tri-tip is also great as a steak, in stroganoffs, kebabs, satays, meat pies, stir fries, chili. Just start by cutting across the grain. I'm Chef Mick Rosacci. I thank you for shopping in our markets, and I thank you for joining me in my kitchen.